EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is in Uptown Charlotte, North Carolina at Bank of America Stadium. Coming up, an important divisional round matchup in the NFC between the Arizona Cardinals and the Carolina Panthers.
Zane Gonzalez to kick off for Arizona.
One of two spots in the NFC title game awaits the winner here as we're underway in the divisional round of the NFL playoffs. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. McCaffrey, and he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver, but he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front, so if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up 3 on that carry.
On 2nd and 7, Bridgewater. He's got a man complete. A game there of 30 big ones.
I don't think anyone would argue that having that extra week definitely helps come playoff time. And those were some fresh legs right there. That extra practice time and planning, certainly in evidence.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for 1st and 10. Bridgewater going to give this to McCaffrey. Oh, he's got a little daylight. Past the 20. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A big hitter there. A first down gain of 26 yards. What did you see there on the defensive side? What allowed that good size run?
Well, they were in a cover two alignment, which means your two safeties are back away from the line of scrimmage. So if you can match up your blocking at the line, at the point of attack, there's usually some room, a big gap between that second level and third, and that's what they were able to exploit.
Brings up ball on the 8, 2nd and 2. Now a run with McCaffrey. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2.
Makes it 3rd and 2.
They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4. 4 yards on the play, and that leads to the 1st and goal. From the gun, Bridgewater. And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. Chandler Jones in there to get him. It's a loss of 5.
Well, that was point counterpoint, wasn't it? They decided to throw for it on 1st and goal. Instead, the defense counters with pressure, and the defense wins, getting a big sack.
Now from the 9, here's 2nd and goal. They'll run with McCaffrey. Only about a yard there as he takes it from the 9 to the 8. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, and now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this 4-down territory? Might he go for it?
What a stand this would be if they can get the stop here. 3rd and goal. From the shotgun, it's Bridgewater. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off inside the 5. And he will take this across midfield and down to the 48-yard line. Nobody ever wants the interception on the opening drive to happen, but when it happens in the playoffs, it feels like it's a bigger deal. What a rough start.
And how about these visitors? The defense just went right on the field and seized momentum, you know, almost like they're saying, okay, no one expects us to win this one, let's go ahead and give them a shock early. Took the ball from the home team and put them in the hole.
Is this crowd one of the best in the league, especially this time of year? It's going to be tough to take them out of it, but that's a heck of a start. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Second and five at the 44-yard line.
This is Jones, and there is nowhere for him to cut back as he's taken down in the backfield. A loss on that play, and now third down gets tougher, third and six.
And it's third down.
The gun, it's Jackson. Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Jeremy Chinn picks it off, and he's able to get it back to right around the 27.
Well, it's a cold night, and whether you're a quarterback that wears a glove on his throwing hand or not, that ball is a rock, Brandon. You've got to really drive it through the cold and the wind, or it can take off on you, and that may have been what happened there.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Well, they were intercepted the first time they had the football, but now they get it back and it's still 0-0.
And because of that, you know what the thought process is? Interception. What interception? It didn't really happen because they gave up no points. So go back on the attack. Go back and run the offense you believe will be successful. Find your playmakers and give them the football.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Out of the gun, Bridgewater gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
Good route, good pickup for first down yardage. And that is a tough one to cover, the angle route, because a running back getting out of the backfield, if you're trying to cover that, especially if you're in the linebacker spot and you're seeing this play develop, he heads out towards the flat first, and that often gets you to overcome.
Is this intercepted? It is. It's intercepted. Picked off by Byron Murphy. First quarter, and now he already has two interceptions.
Yeah, he's got to guard against being tentative from this point forward, though. He's got to still make the right reads, make the proper throws. I've seen guys in this league throw four interceptions in a game and win. He's got to understand, put it behind you, keep pressing forward.
And he'll be taken down at the 20 after a gain of just one.
The ball carrier.
Well, it's hard to have vision as a runner and find a hole when there's nothing but defenders in your way. They stacked that one up really well. But give him credit. Instead of trying to bounce it out and turn it into a big play, which might have turned into a big loss, Kai just took his medicine there and took the 1 yard.
This time, Jackson will throw it. That ball complete to Isabella. This will be a gain of about 8 to the 27-yard line. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. No score after one on EA Sports. On second down, but it didn't help at all, and now they're looking at third down here. They go play action with Jackson. He's going to fire one deep over the middle into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Jeremy Chinn picks it off, and they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to unnerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one, or does he find a way to pull it together and become sharp again?
And good downhill running. He's got 6 yards down to the 13.
Well, they did throw interceptions on their last two drives, so no surprise at all they decided to start it with a running play. I'm actually a little bit surprised, though, that they got as much out of it as they did.
Yeah, decent little gain. Puts them in a pretty good spot for second down. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina. From 13 yards out, as his guys are on the board first here tonight. Well, we had the scoreless first quarter of play. We sure didn't have to wait long into the second quarter to get some action on the scoreboard.
So was the first quarter a feeling out process? I mean, that was an interesting quarter, wasn't it? Because we had some action. We had some good play. Just didn't have any points. So now it's game on.
Taken about 7 yards deep. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line.
At their own 17-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. To this point, the results have not been good. 2 possessions, 2 turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball. Try and get things settled down a little bit.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. They'll run it with Jones. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that's going to lead to a 3rd and 12. Jackson, and this will be caught. It's Isaiah Hodgins, and he is going to have a Cardinals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. His first reception of the divisional round matchup, and it's good for a first down as well. Shotgun. This into the hands of his running back, Ronald Jones. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well.
First down.
Out of the shotgun, it's Jones. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Gun. Jackson. He's going to fire this thing deep right side. And that's caught inside the 30. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 27-yard line. He got 29 yards that time. Now a first down carry by Jones. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're a back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit.
Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
And that one complete to Hodgins. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Arizona.
Jones. And this play gets blown up. They'll lose yardage back at the 17. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
Second quarter action, 2 minutes to go on divisional round weekend. We've done all year that coming up at halftime, we will visit with Jonathan Coachman standing by at Orlando. He'll let you know what's going on here on a very eventful divisional round weekend. On second and 12, Jackson open here is Allison. That's complete. And able to get this down inside the 15 to either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do, you got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end, take some easier completions.
The interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. Jackson. This will be caught just inside the 10. And they're able to corral him right around the 8, and that's short of the first down. Just a 5-yard pickup, and it leads to fourth down.
Fourth down.
On fourth down, here's Zane Gonzalez for the Cardinal field goal. From the right hash, and this one just a chippy. Gonzalez's kick is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So a dozen plays on that drive, CD, but in the end, it yields just the 3 points.
Well, they were able to keep the defense on the field for a long time, but let's be honest about it. That was about as unsatisfying a drive as you're going to get. 12 plays and you only get 3 points out of it. Not quite the ending they were looking for.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. Still more than a minute to go, so there is time if they want to mount something here.
Not only time, but they have 3 timeouts at their disposal as well, so that changes everything that you're doing here. Without those timeouts, you can only work the sidelines, hoping to get out of bounds. Here, the middle of the field is still available because you can call timeout and regroup.
And his throw's going to be incomplete. Darius Leonard, the linebacker, able to break that one up.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation. That's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
Bridgewater from the gun on third down. And it falls incomplete after almost being intercepted. A pick there would have been great. The good news for the defense now, it's fourth down.
Pilardi on to punt for the Panthers.
Pilardi now on to punt as he sends this one away. And he fields it cleanly. A nice return that time of about 14 yards. And the Cards will take over, first and 10. ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. Operating from the gun, Jackson. That's caught by Ware. Yeah, he will go out right near the 35-yard line. First catch for him in these playoffs. He was held without one last week, but he's got a first down on that effort. From the gun, Jackson. Yeah, quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll cross over out of bounds right at the 25.
Number 89.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
25-yard line.
Looking to throw again on second down. Jackson. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining.
In the end zone.
An incomplete pass on second down leads us to third and inches. Play action. It's Jackson. Strong coverage by Carolina. And on we go to fourth down.
To the sideline and incomplete. It's fourth down.
And for the second time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. Made his first, this now from 42 yards out. Gonzalez's kick is good. And they'll get it back within a point at 7-6. So, yes, they'll still be down going into intermission, but the deficit is now made even smaller, very manageable.
Yeah, and if nothing haywire happens here in his last couple of precious seconds, they will go into the locker room with a nice bounce in their step, having gotten a little bit closer on the scoreboard.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play.
And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of this first half of play. So we've come upon halftime here in this NFC divisional round matchup as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! Trip to the NFC title game hanging in the balance. Second half action back underway. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And the half will begin with a touchback. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And Charles, they're certainly still right in this game, but they need that offense to wake up and in a hurry.
Yeah, I like the way you put it. They certainly did seem to sleepwalk a bit in the first half. Now that their defense has done its job, it's their turn now to go out and try and get some points.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks.
Arizona.
Jackson on first down, sliding out, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Yetur Gross-Matos, able to run him down for a loss of 12 that time.
It's second down.
Come on. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Another try after the first down sack. Jackson under pressure again, and down he goes again. Brian Burns, he's the one that drops him this go-around, and that pass rush getting strong here, back-to-back sacks. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Now Jackson. He sets up the screen to Jones. 14 yards, but they're still well shy of the first as that leads to fourth down.
They dialed up the screen pass on third down, and for a second it looked like it was all going to come together, and they had a chance to pick up a first down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. And this will be out of bounds, and they spotted it at the 15-yard line. Not too bad.
At their own 15-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to, and if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. Give him five on the screen play, and that'll set up a third down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
The Cards going nickel, an extra defensive back out there now on third down. Throwing, Bridgewater. That's going to be complete to his tight end, Everett. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Excellent play there on third down. Give him 25 yards. On first down, this is McCaffrey. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. Then he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just so quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Second and 10 here as we sit in the third quarter of this divisional round matchup. To throw, Bridgewater. Open man is Robbie Anderson. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
Brings up third and seven.
Throwing is Bridgewater. He can run for it, and he will. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down.
When they watch film of this game and hand out the grade sheets, he's going to really like getting a double plus on this play. Why? He scrambles and picks up a first down. But what else does he do? Protects himself by sliding and avoiding the big hit. Double plus, big time play.
McCaffrey. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
Brings up second and 11 at the 46-yard line.
On second and 11 now. Bridgewater, that's complete to the tight end, Everett. And he will take it across for Panthers' touchdown. Gerald Everett, 46 yards. And the Panthers, they widen their lead.
For a big tight end, he can sure move like a slot receiver when he gets ahead of steam going. And as a defensive back, you've got a big decision to make when he's moving like that.
Point after here coming up. And it's up. It's good. Our score, 14-6.
Makes the score Panthers 14, Cardinals 6.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And he returns this to the 22.
Cardinals take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense, and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first down. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down. Here's Jones. He'll take this from the 40 up to the 45 for a gain of 5. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. One quarter remains for a trip to the NFC title game. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. A big play, 3rd and 2. This crowd dying for a stop. Jackson to throw. It's caught. Jones. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. That goes for 14 yards. First down, Cardinals.
And that's a much needed first down right there. Look, they're down by 8. So logic says they don't have to get a touchdown out of this drive. But the way things are going, I don't know if I'd put it in the hands of my defense here. You might not get the ball back at all. So if a fourth down situation comes up, I'm thinking hard about going for it right here and right now.
Back at the 42.
So still 14 yards to go, 2nd down. Operating from the gun, Jackson. He'll find Hodgins there, complete. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face 3rd down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on 2nd down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives a much better opportunity to convert on 3rd down.
To throw is Jackson on 3rd down. He'll let this go for the end zone. And unable to connect. Incomplete. I'll give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up 4th down.
They'll probably spend a little extra time dissecting the game film after this one. I think the part of their plan was to hit them over the top of the deep ball. They've been unsuccessful all night.
They're going on 4th down. It's Jackson. And for a 3rd time tonight, he's intercepted. Jeremy Chin picks it off. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick 6 for a Panther touchdown. That's the story of the game. They've been suffocating all game long on defense. They were suffocating there again in a big way.
And they've done it not just by out-athleting them, which is often the case, but by being able to adjust to anything they tried to throw at them and beating them into the punch each and every time. This was a defense that was well prepared.
Oh, And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. We'll see if they can band back together after the pick six. It hurt badly, but still within striking distance. A two-score game with a good chunk of time on the clock. And the first play of the drive there is incomplete.
Well, they certainly did a nice job there, picking him up out of the backfield and then running stride for stride with him. That's good coverage, and it led to an incompletion.
Jackson now on second and 10. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 22 yards on the catch and run, a first down.
A gain of 22 yards.
From the gun, it's Jackson. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
To throw again on second down, Jackson. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked up by Michael Davis. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line.
But they had designs of kind of wiggling their way back into this one. That hurts their chances right there.
They had to put it mildly. Look at the lead. Look at the deficit. Trying to make a play downfield. Everyone seeking to be somewhat the hero. Didn't turn out that way at all. And you're exactly right. It's going to take a lot for them to have a chance to win this one now.
Number 22.
Darren Lee there to get him down. Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
Call it a gain of four there, so it sets up a big play here. Third and a yard.
Third and one.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. Breaks the tackle. He's got room to run. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And the Cardinals have got it. Going the other way. And he'll bring this one back to the 29.
Partner, that one looked like it was over. I mean, they had control, had the football, and the defense had to make a play in order to keep them in the game. That's exactly what they did.
And now that door ajar, two-score game. So hold on here. Not done in the fourth. After the fumble recovery, it's Jackson. And incomplete on the deep ball. Andy Isabella was the intended target, but it'll be second down.
I like the thought process there. They connected on a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of three. And guess what? It brings up third down. Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the top plays that these guys like to run. The best runs for the top running back. Those are the ones you focus on and want to take away. And they've done that pretty successfully in this game.
Jackson to throw on third down, and this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked up by Michael Davis, and they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. I'm starting to wonder, Charles, if five interceptions, is that the last that we've seen of him?
Well, I think that a lot of people hope that's the last they've seen of him in this game, probably including himself. If this were baseball, the manager would have been at the mound already and asked for the ball, and he'd be in there getting a shower. But in football, you might have to go stand on the sideline and watch the rest of it and see if your backup can do any better.
Brings up second and nine.
They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. He'll be hit down at the 33. 5 yards on the play. The recipe's pretty simple, I think, right? Just give your superstar the ball, continue to feed him.
Yeah, don't overthink this one, right? Make sure he's touching the football, but you're also counting on his intelligence in playing the game as well. If it's not there, don't force the run. Just make sure you hang on to the football and keep the clock ticking.
Now this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. To throw is Bridgewater. And this is caught, but I don't think he stayed in bounds. No, he didn't. It's incomplete. The throw took him past the boundary, and it's fourth.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
So with that, you figure, yeah, this game's pretty much out of reach at this point.
Yeah, it's going to take a heck of a comeback to come from three scores down, but don't change that channel. Don't go away. Miracles can happen, and you want to be here in case it does.
You're a company man.
Aren't I, though?
And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
At their own 18-yard line.
Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And they knew this would be tough on the road, divisional round, and that has certainly been the case with the deficit they face in this fourth quarter. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. It's a gain of 34. Defensively, I know they have the comfortable lead here in the fourth, but they do not want to give up big plays like that.
They want to finish strong. So oftentimes in this situation, you tighten up underneath in your coverage, and you bring your safeties back. They can pick up anything that leaks through. But in the meantime, upfield, you're making plays on the football.
Gonna go down. They sack him back at the 42. Brian Burns, his second sack of the night. And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19. Another try after the first down sack. Jackson. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Brian Burns able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening. Take a minute to see how you can improve your team. Shorty stepped on my off whites. Okay, now wait. Gotta get the bag in racks every day. Don't tell me to relax, I can't. I'm a snake. Got a new press, those and the J's in a way. Got a new press, watch ready. Don't take time. My hope when I hop if it's up too hot. And you wanna play ball, hit a 3-point shot.
but it's my court, got a block on lock.
I done made about a million and I'm only 19. I see water dripping on a white tee. And shorty got a man, but she saying wife me. I got chest coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then